That might have been the worst human being that's ever been at one of my shows.
So North Carolina passed a law that said that you had to use the bathroom of the gender you were assigned at birth.
Woo!
No!
No!
We're gonna explore this.
So you don't believe in gender-neutral bathrooms? I get that I've already lost you, but...
You haven't been funny for a while, so I'm still trying to catch up.
Oh, I haven't been funny for a while? No, that's totally okay. I get it.
About 5 minutes, though, but it's all good, because I've liked you on Facebook. It's all good.
You liked me on Facebook. And so, did you like two Heckler clips, but you didn't actually understand what I do?
No, but you probably asked, why are you... surprised when you get a response.
I don't know for sure if I'm remembering this correctly, even though I wrote the bit. The exact words I used was North Carolina passed a law that said you could only use the restroom of the gender you were assigned at birth. Now, what part of that to you is a question?
It's not. I'm just a firm believer that that's a great idea.
Why?
Because
he is under the belief that trans people only use the bathroom to rape little girls.
And they should not feel any type of a 40-year-old man cutting into a little girl's washroom.
Question for you.
Feel
sir?
Little girls XX.
That's what he said. And apparently doesn't think trans people have to go to the bathroom for any other reason.
Why is it taking you 17 minutes to say this, sir?
There are certain things he did say that I do agree with. I don't say what they are, but, you know.
I've been talking for how long? That's what you fucking paid me for, you dummy! Do you understand why everyone's facing this way? How old should a girl be using the restroom by herself?
I have no idea. I'm not a parent, so I have no idea.
No idea. So when you... No.
Let
I appreciate that, but believe me, I'm going to give you what you want.
I asked him if he's ever seen a father bring a little girl to the men's room. And he said he hadn't, because he's a liar.
I asked you a yes or no question, and you're like, oh, now it's my time.
No, you didn't.
Yes, he did!
I get why you don't find me funny. You don't understand shit, man. I said, are you aware that little girls get brought to the men's room by their fathers?
In private, yes.
In private?
What?
That never happens in a public restroom?
They go into a
school. Oh, I totally get it. This is the first time you've ever been in public. Sir, how old are you?
You keep cutting me off, so there you go.
Well, no, I asked you a yes or no question, and you said yes, and then I moved on to the next question.
Little girls, old men in a bathroom, you're okay with that?
Should you be in a bathroom with little girls?
No.
So then never fucking use a public restroom again, you dummy. Let me just say this.
No.
If you hear that a little girl is peeing and you immediately think it's sexual, that is a problem Ooh. That you have. Yes. Do you think for a fuck, hold on a second, do you think for a fucking second that someone goes through 8 years of hormone treatments and being castigated by society just so they can use a bathroom next to a little girl?
I asked him whether or not men can be rapists. And he seemed to not believe that.
Yeah, I mean, the evidence isn't in on that one.
Yeah, absolutely not.
It's just, unfortunately.
Yeah, and I'm not stupid enough to be like, all trans people are good people. Obviously, there are assholes in every walk of life. But the idea that straight men never sexually assault anyone, preposterous.
How many biological men have raped people? You want to fucking do the numbers? How many?
More. 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 Happens at women's You know the fact.
Guys, I'm going to get back on the show because I have just learned, apparently, that more women are rapists than men. Which, I didn't realize, but boy, what a weird world we live in.
Child abuse, not women. Not
child abuse. More women have committed child abuse than men.
More women.
Well then, sir, you should stop talking to women. Don't support that. I mean, they've already stopped talking to you.
I even try to walk him down the logic of him getting upset at a progressive comedian for being progressive. I'm unapologetically politically progressive on all of my social media. I was like, how did you get here? Why are you at this show? This was a Sunday night. This wasn't like, hey, it's the weekend, date night, let's see what there is to do. And Vancouver has a million other options. There were probably five other comedians in town that night, even on a Sunday. And he came to see me. Of all the comedians in all of Vancouver, he had to walk into my show. All
right, sir. Sir, hold on a second. Are you a sports fan?
I used to play sports, but I'm not a sports fan.
You used to play sports, but you're not a sports fan. Do you like movies?
Not
particularly. God, you make everything difficult. Do you like television? What is your favorite television show?
Yeah, but wanting little girls and men.
Like television?
No.
No. Do you like music?
Yes.
Yes. What music do you like?
Move on.
No, no, no. I'm trying to understand you. You spoke up to me. What music do you like? What music do you... How? This is an easy question. What music do you like?
90s stuff.
90s stuff.
Yeah, there you go.
90s stuff. Everything from the 90s.
Yeah.
Everything. Can you name a fucking artist?
Born in the 80s and raised in the 90s. What, like, how hard is that?
I'm trying to give you a metaphor so you understand what you did tonight. Is there a song or an artist that you enjoy?
I enjoy a lot of 90s rap, a lot of 90s R&B, a lot of...
90s R&B. Okay. If you were to go to a 90s R&B show, would you be mad at them that they're not playing country music?
Give it a minute.
I love watching 300 people know exactly where I'm going and he's like, carry the two. My point is, sir, I haven't even gotten to the main part of my set yet, which I will still get to.
Songs aren't okay with little kids.
What I'm trying to tell you is that you picked my show. I didn't pick you. And I would never pick you. And so this is the show you bought tickets to. That I just did four shows in the fucking Dakotas and I didn't deal with this shit. Holy shit. I'm sorry that you spent all that gas money coming up from Surrey, but... Is he gone?
Yeah, and the pint glasses under.
Holy shit. Okay, by the way, folks, I'm sorry that, I truly am sorry that that happened, and I will do the entire set I was planning on doing. What I was trying to do was let him, just give him enough rope to hang himself. And instead, he did that, and he was like, this is how I masturbate. And I was doing my best to be like, what music do you like? I like music. Well, what kind of music? The 90s. That's not a kind of music. That's an era. Do you like 90s hip-hop? What does that have to do with little girl? Fucking focus. Do you understand that as an American, how relieved I am that it's not just our education system? Is I know what I'm gonna say in the rest of my set. And he really really got offended at the little shit. I want to apologize to everyone that America is bleeding up.
You believe, hold on. I have to honestly record this. Honestly. Like, honestly. You just said, correct me if I'm wrong, that you just said that you're okay with little girls and men being in the same washroom at the same time, right?
Oh my God, yes.
Don't worry, man, yes? It's getting recorded.
So, hold on. Girls.
I also believe in people coming and interrupting a comedy show, drinking eight fucking beers, and then interrupting for 30 minutes.
He asked the question.
I know.
When he asked the question about little girls being in the same washroom with men. And you
didn't ask a question. You brought it.
No, he brought it. He brought that up. Grown ass men.
When did he say grown ass men?
Grown ass men. 80 year old men. Little girls in the bathroom together. Doing little dances.
Wait, sorry. Which side are you on this?
I'm Steve Turman.
I'm kidding.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. No, that was fantastic.
It's a shame because, you know, the thing is, this happens all the time, where 85-year-old men and 3-year-old girls are just in the washroom at the same time, and they're... It's just such a thing that's always happening. Everybody believes it. It's not a straw man bullshit thing at all. And it's certainly enough to get super angry about and hijack a comedy show, you know, when you're, I don't know, 6-8 beers in. So I'm just sorry that I couldn't live up to his, he's actually still going.
Now this is secondhand. I can't vouch for this. I did not see this. But another guy in the audience decides to help. He was in the lobby. He hears all the commotion. He goes outside. And his intent is to just say, hey, man, I understand it's embarrassing. You took an L in front of a crowd of people. Go home. There's no upside here. Just go home. You'll be fine. He gets 1 foot out the door. And this guy yells,
I'm just saying, don't call me a name for no reason. You don't know me. I'm just a guy fucking working here. How about that? How about I'm just a dude at work? I just came out to have a cigarette.
You're working?
Yeah, let's say I am.
So, the North Carolina law said that they had to use the restroom of the gender they were assigned at birth. The language that they used was different than that because they think that whatever genitalia you're born with is who you are. Which is bizarre to me because those same people refer to their car as a she. If a vagina makes you a she and your car is a she, can you point out on the Honda Accord? I'm thinking behind the gas cap? Is that? Maybe the tailpipe? I don't know what that. Look, I don't want to kink shame, but they said that it was to protect women. Because if there's one thing that we all know about the Republican Party of North Carolina, it's how much they care about women. They're like, we have to protect these women so that they can use the restroom and then not have bodily autonomy and make 70 cents on the dollar. It's important. And that is an exaggeration. For comedic effect, it is 73 cents. So they used fearmonger. That's what that guy was doing. He was fearmonger. Saying things like, well, if a trans woman can use a woman's room, well, then a man can just tell someone they're trans and use a woman's room. And I'm like, tell who? The bouncer outside the woman's room? You don't scan your dick to open the door. Present genitals, boop! Like, that's not what's happening. The most amazing part of it is that the thing where he said about you haven't been funny yet. Do you realize what I opened with? I opened by saying, Me Too was a good thing. You shouldn't rape people. and that if you feel attacked by me saying you shouldn't rape people, you're the one I'm making fun of. And he was like, I feel attacked. Those are literally the jokes I did. Oh, and then I talked about being tall. Was he little? And I don't mean to put this on other shorter people, but I think that's what did it. I know he was little, but I was just wondering if he was little. I just love the idea that my most viral video this year was the one where I was wearing a dress.
Are you gonna post this?
Am I gonna post this?
Yeah.
What the fuck do you think? I was gonna say, turns out Canadians can be assholes too.
He's not Canadian.
This is, you say he's not Canadian. Yes.
No, I just talked to him outside, he's not Canadian.
You talked to him outside, he's not Canadian.
He's not Canadian.
Where did he get deported from? Is he American?
Douchebagville.
Why is he hanging out outside? Because he wants to see if he can fight me.
He's literally saying he's waiting for you.
He's waiting for me.
I will take the ball.
You don't have to, because all 300 of us will. Look, I don't believe in escalating a physical violence, no. But I'm also 6'4", 220. So I think I'm gonna be all right. Although if he's not Canadian, he has a gun. Someone said not here. Oh, come on, when you cross the border, you know how you prove you don't have a gun? You say, I don't. Your border security is based on an honor system and the tip of a hat, like that. You planning on murdering anyone? Well, no, officer. All right, go ahead. He'd have told me if he was going to. He'd have slipped up. Now, and not earlier, now is the participatory part of the program. So please help me welcome back up to the stage Andrew Rivers and John Bandler. Someone just yelled missing somebody. Yeah, Evan's the new guy on the tour. He hasn't earned it yet.
Or do you mean you want that guy to come up here? It's a joke, relax. How does Vancouver compare to Pennsylvania?
Well, usually, quite favorably. I like Vancouver a great deal for the most part. This is why I was so confused tonight, because I find it to be such a progressive, forward-thinking, and chill city. Like Vancouver, for the most part, is just like, yeah, look, we want the best for everybody. Whatever's cool is cool. And then the storm crow closed. And I think it started a ripple effect. I hope he was drunk. That was a sober person?
I sent you a photo of his seat.
Oh my God. Is it wet?
No, yeah, just like the 8 beer cans there.
Oh my God, that is the... Wow, that guy's the most Chad dude I've ever seen.
Looks like Conor McGregor, kind of. Like,
holy shit.
He's got that Nazi haircut.
Do you have a weird filter on, or is that the shape of his head?
I don't know if there's a filter that shapes a head different. If there is, please tell me.
The girl said it was a Bumble date.
Imagine being like that on a date. At a Bumble date, a first date.
Wait, isn't Bumble the one where the women have to make the first move?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, he made the last. Yeah, that's the feminist app. And he's just like, this is where I can bang feminists, right?
She's like, I have to go to the bathroom. He's like, which one? Because there's an 80-year-old man and a 3-year-old girl, and they're holding hands in the bathroom.
Also, all the bathrooms here are all gender bathrooms. Like, this whole venue is like all gender, and he's like, this seems like a great place for a show.
By the way, I think when he's like, women commit more abuse, I think that's because she was just going, shut the fuck up.
Ow.
Also, he's still out there waiting for me. That means she fucking left.
I will say, as of when I last checked out there, he was still out there on the corner. Probably don't kick his ass. I don't know. Like,
I think Mother Nature did that already. I saw the shape of his head.
Fair enough.
Finally, the theater threatens to call the police, and so the heckler leaves. Or so we think. Dun, dun, dun. Dramatic music playing. The guy leaves. But by leaving, I mean he just goes around the corner. He waits for the end of the show, which is an hour. He stands there by himself on the street corner. As soon as the show lets out an hour later, he sprints back over and starts jawing back and forth with a few trans women.
So after a Q&A, I'm selling merch, and this guy comes up to me and is like, that guy's still out there, and he's like picking fights. So I go out there, and that's when I saw like the three trans women were in his face. They were, you know, antagonizing or whatever. They were like, fuck you or whatever. But again, he denied the right to exist. And again, he's sitting there saying like, you're a freak, you're men. He'll say like, I'm the victim or whatever, or like, I'm just doing whatever. And then 1 second later, he'll switch to, because again, if this was about little girls and really wanted caring about their safety, he wouldn't immediately switch to the most bigoted response.
If you were the fucking, I would knock the shit out of you.
Now, the women surround him, and he is not happy about that. So, he's going back and forth with them. At one point, he says to one of them that she has a dick, and she was wearing a dress, so she just lifted up her dress, was like, where's my dick? Which was just, what a badass. Like, that was very cool. That's a very good reason to flash somebody. Another guy, completely unrelated, who hadn't seen the show, gets in between. You'd think to defuse things, but no, that's not why he was there.
I'll step on your fucking toe.
You're about to get physical here. You're about to get physical.
He seems to want this guy to escalate. You know, his body language is certainly as such. He's kind of pushing against the guy. And instead of leaving...
Why are you still here?
It's called freedom, okay. Motherfucker.
You're free.
No, I have freedom.
Freedom.
No,
yeah,
freedom.
I would encourage you to find another corner to be an asshole at.
No, no, no.
You can be an asshole wherever you want. You can be an asshole somewhere else.
I was walking by.
You walk by to intentionally piss people off.
No, I walk by.
Okay.
And
so,
where are you going?
Freedom.
You shut the fuck up.
And John, also, I think it was at this point that you were, like, saying to the women, like, he's not worth it.
Yeah. So I just tried to de-escalate, sort of get in between everybody. And I talked to the guy, and I was like, stop, let's not, like, you know, take this any further. And then the guy was like, thank you, I'm here. And I'm like, listen, you're not the victim here, but please go home. Like, it's fine. And then he called me fat immediately again.
Oh, my God, I didn't know that.
Like, oh, yeah. You don't agree with me 100%, you fat fuck. And I was like, okay, please go home still. I did my best, but I'm just too fat to continue to break up this fight.
Oh, my God. So the tatted up guy gets right up in the heckler's face. And the heckler takes a swing at him. Fairly pathetic swing, but it's a swing. And that is, I understand... Tatted up guy shouldn't have been pushing him, but that was not self-defense. Mm-hmm. Self-defense would have been leaving an hour earlier, or any time up until then. Once he takes a swing, the staff says, we've called the cops. The tatted guy was like, oh, I'm getting out of here. So clearly he's got passed. That guy scattered. So he was one of these things, I can't be arrested a seventh time.
Just like a cartoon. Just
yeah, there was a cloud of smoke behind.
Smoke.
Yeah, sound effects. The sidewalk burned a little bit. So now the cops are on their way, and the guy still won't leave. He's drunk and has just taken a swing at someone on camera, and he still won't leave. The cops get there.
We're good a bit. Okay. Let me out. Good luck.
I had more babies.
Hey, man.
Good excuse.
Man.
They basically say to him, look, just... go. Nothing will happen if you just go. They're giving him every opportunity.
But if you refuse to calm down, you're going to be arrested, all right? So, at this point, I'll give you an opportunity to walk away. If you want to leave now, you're welcome to leave. But if you refuse to leave, then what's coming?
And he just keeps mouthing off. And so eventually they search him. And they find a metric ton of cocaine. I don't know if it was a metric ton. I'm assuming metric just because it's, you know, we're in Canada. But
yeah, liters of coke.
Yeah, liters of coke. They find a Celsius worth of cocaine. They arrest the guy. And I don't know what they're going to charge him with. Disorderly conduct, trespassing, narcotics, hate crime. There were many things they could charge him with. I did find out some other things afterward. Other people who are at the show have been messaging us ever since, sending us pictures and video and also some stories. This is secondhand, I don't know the validity, but one guy said that he used to work with the guy. The heckler was a delivery driver at his company and was fired for saying a whole bunch of racist things. And while I don't know 100% if that's true, it sounds true. The theater staff was fantastic. The theater staff had our back every step of the way. My favorite part of it was after it's all done, we are behind the theater loading the van. The cops drive by with, I assume, the guy in the back, considering they put him in the back of the car. And I just give a little nod of like, thank you for not only handling this, but not escalating. Like, this was a very different experience than I often see with police in the States. They gave him every chance to go home, which I don't even know if I was a fan of that.
They were talking to him for so long. They talked to him before he got cuffed. They talked to him after he got cuffed. Like, every chance it'd be like, just go home. Please, yeah. Conor McGregor, just go home. And he was like, no.
They're driving by, and I give him a little like nod and a wave. And then I realize, oh, I was not involved in this from the cop's perspective at all. And so I'm just some guy in an alley being like, hello. I just hope from the back of the car, the last thing he saw before he went to jail was me just being like, hello. There is a wonderful selfie that Eben took of Eben just smiling with the guy over his shoulder getting cuffed.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Despite that bullshit, I want you to think about for a moment how it happened. Because when he yelled out, like when he wooed something pretty offensive, I didn't jump down his throat right away. I wanted him to explain himself. And the reason for that was because I was hoping we could have a conversation. I was hoping I could show him logically he was wrong. Now, to do that, it takes basic comprehension, but I tried. And that's what I encourage all of you to do as well. There are plenty of people who are just as much of a caveman as that guy. I talked about it before. Every one of us has the chance to take our knuckles off the ground, and there are some guys who are like, no, it's more comfortable. I'll get band-aids, don't worry about it. But when that does happen, talk to the person. Because maybe you can talk to them. Maybe they're going to be that guy who's going to bang his head against the wall and think he can solve his problems by fighting me. But maybe you'll change somebody's mind. And I hope you give that a shot at least. You guys have a good time tonight. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for supporting Live Crowd. And most of all, thank you all for listening. Have a good night.
I'll be honest. I thought the show was great.
It was a really good show, yeah.
Yeah, tense at times.
Yeah.
But overall, thanks, Vancouver.
Yeah, thank you.
Welcome to Vancouver!
Should people come see a Steve Hofstetter show?
Yeah, this is what happens. Woo!